Works, and you saw it just pop up a little bit. It's at 34,200 now. The water level will keep rising. It starts rising back up once it gets at 50,000. So there you go. Next up is one of the newest feature that is gonna probably, well, it could irritate some people, but it's probably gonna be a blessing for others. And I tried to come up with a really good balance. Hello, source button. Let's see. Awesome. Source options are always cool. Let's go. I wish they'd get subscribe options. That would be even better. But hey, source options work for now. I really like the looks of the map. You know, with the buildings around the outside, it kind of looks good driving around here. I am going to show you feature number...
What?
No, but you just said the next thing can irritate people, or...
Well, you know. It could. Some people might think it's, you know, what we're trying to do is create something that fits as many play styles as possible. So, yeah, this one here will please a lot of people, for sure.
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about now.
What I put in front of the speedway.
Yeah, now, I can't believe I forgot that.
Yeah. Well, we're giving people some time to refresh their streams if the source option screwed them up, so... Alright. Basically, there's... And you saw a glimpse of it in the store earlier, and I will set one up right here just for giggles. Just show you how it works. Category. Mods. Placeables. A $250,000 construction company. I need to get money. Let's try the money option here. Take some money out of my bank.
Jess been standing here the whole time.
Jess probably fishing. And placeables and construction company buy, and you basically need to find a relatively flat piece of land to drop your construction company and go boom. And here we have a new construction company. Doug Yair, thanks for the follow. So basically what a construction company does is it creates project points. This is McDonald Construction. Nice little trailer. You can't really go in it, but it looks good. I just put it all together myself. Not too bad for not knowing how to make models, just taking pieces. And to give you an idea of what that does is they create 6 project points per day. Not a lot. But if you are one of those people that ends up having way too much money and not enough time to build all the other stuff, or maybe you just want to, you're not into building the factories, but you wish there was another alternative, this is for you. So at the construction companies, which I already have one preloaded here with project points, I just loaded in, I actually have 100, it says 99, but what we'll do is, I got another one down here, I preloaded that one. 6 points per day per construction company. Have $2 million, buy yourself a bunch. You're only going to get 6 project points out of each one of them. Now, this one here has been running for just a little bit over an hour or a few hours, and it only has 1 point. But there, I want to make sure I have 100. I have 100 in my trailer, and that's where we come over to where I used to have a building, used to be a cement plant. And if you notice, we have 0% project. Now, before we go through all this, if you decide to fast track, your numbers, as far as how much is needed for the levels, do not get updated, so you're going to have to manually keep track or just fill them up a little bit at a time. Now, unless these guys want to get launched in outer space, I presume they might not want to be on... Do you guys really want to get launched into outer space?
That can be fun.
Because when I dump this, anybody that's on this slab could end up in outer space. So basically, your project points. Go in here.
See, I want to see if I bunk out of space. I want to see if I get launched.
This is going to go really fast. And it might get bugged out. It's a first-time test.
Nothing happened.
Well, buildings appeared behind us. Now, it is at 100% project. It will probably take an update next hour or two before the rest of the building appears.
There's a floating sign right here.
Like I said, it'll probably take another hour or two before the rest of the building appears. On the server, it's one of those server-y glitches. But I'm going to fast forward time. With a password that I can't show everybody. Real quick, hang on. And back over to that. And let's fast forward and see what happens. It may require a log out and back in, but the factory will all appear eventually. And that is one of those things that just happens because the UPK can't keep up. So I will log out and back in and see if it's all there for me. What's interesting is it should have put the fence in and it did not. So it looks like we probably have a little more work to do. It looks like it skipped right over a couple stages. But project being at 100% might require a save game and a reload back in. So let's see what happens. And one more time with the Be Right Back screen for my login.
The yellow dumping square is gone.
Yes, it should disappear. And the rest of the building probably will synchronize. We're hoping. If you log out and back in. It may need to be tweaked so that, which I can do. If this does not work on the server and it still is bugged, I can slow down the process of stuff, the points when you put them in, put them through another processor. So have no fear, this feature will work 100% when it comes out. The Beast Kyle 21, thanks for the follow. The UPK is just a little tricky when you have so much stuff going all at once. But the fact is the factory has 100% projects, so it is completely built. It just might require a restart. If I have to slow down, like I said, a new processor in there won't be hard at all to transfer the project points slower. I never tried it all at once on a server. Let's synchronize up with these crazy people. It's getting dark out.
Oh, the building's there.
Yeah, they saw my password again, but I don't care. It's not like they can get on our server yet. We'll have to change that when,
The building's there.
The whole building's there now?
Yeah.
I'm gonna let the time roll till it gets daylight again. Is somebody in my truck? Or am I...
Your truck shows us took up hot product, didn't it?
Did somebody message Chris the mumble information? I don't have it memorized.
He'll have to wait. Alright, so you can see me just loading back out and back in, as dark it is, as it is. Our building has appeared. So that is one of those server glitches, and it always has happened when you switch levels. And also my steering wheel glitch is when I tab out and back in, I can't steer. Let me reset that real quick. Zing, zing. Okay. So yes, you can fast track building your factories. Somebody just turned on their lights behind me. And 6 project points an hour. It's just another way to do it. If you are not so much into the building. It will work for any of the buildings on the map, including the dock, fishing docks, or the bridges. It just, those little things just create project points. I'm getting away from that crazy person. Fast forwarding till we get daylight again. Although the construction sites companies do look kind of cool at night, as you can see. We'll swing by again. Because they got all the reflectors around the outside. Daylight comes. So I'm pretty sure we covered. Let's go back over and check that other sign real quick.
I'm not crazy.
Yes, you are. Anybody who didn't see something they want to see again? Hey,
I just drive fast.
We can show you. We've got lots of. Actually, there's some more deck. We'll go through the White Farm area because I did a little bit
I'm
of.
I'm raging proud of it.
You guys are all crazy.
I feel the need for speed.
Okay, let's see. Where am I going? I don't know. One of the things I need. Thanks, Gavin1089 as well for the follow. All right. Here we are. We're going to go back here and see if there really was blue or white on this sign, or if it was just a graphical anomaly by S7 Davis when we zipped by. Nope. Looks good to me. Does it still look white to you? It looks all white to me. All right to me. Oh, yeah. I forgot something. Let's go down this way. There's so many things. And we're... still going. Here, we can stop time. Look at all the money the server has. That's just insane. Alright, dead people in the cemetery count. Actually, it's probably the same as the last time we were here. If anybody doesn't know, I have one left in my trailer, because we did have one extra project point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6! The cemetery is a time played clock, 1660 hours on the map, and 6 cemetery stones. Dead people die every 250 hours, and give you their inheritance, which is random, $10,000 to $100,000. I still have one in my truck because I picked up an extra one. That's why I got the logo still. Onward to a little horse or cow farm down here. Yeah, the cow farm. Hey, thank you, awesome kid 19, for the follow, and XLRCX Unsparring for the host. Thank you very much. Glenn Falcon, if he's out there, he's the one that actually did, and this is white. Yes, it is. It's a different sign. But he submitted this from the billboard making mod class that Big Daddy did. He created a billboard. I changed the colors a little bit, but that's about it. And we decided that it was a pretty cool thing, and we added him down here. So that was Glenn Falcon with some crazy number after his name. But we decided to add those in because they came off the other signs. So you do have a sign there that tells you all of the products, as well as if you're on the front side, the blue digital displays are on each of the silos as well through here. Things that need to be done. Well, we still got to fix that silly sign that keeps falling over, so I think it's coming out. That's down here by the, yeah, everybody knows it. It's always on the ground. I've tried to get that sucker to stand up a million times. I don't know what it is about those signs, but they're painting the, you know what. So, it's coming out. But we'll go through the forest. It's up the hill up there. We don't need to show it to you. Then I show you this way. This way around the map. Through the forest. All right, good questions, actually. Can we release the mod pack for the map before it gets on the map gets on Giants? We will release our mod pack on our website, on the forums, and a link to it before, so you can have all everything except for the map file. However, to keep everything according to rules and not jeopardize our map being pulled from the contest, mods that we have not altered at all, or that are the exact, like certain ones like the Bible Object script, you need to download from their website, at least for the time being. So we will have all the link. We'll have a complete list and then our mod pack after it. If there's a mod that has not been altered, you'll have a direct link so you know what you need to get. And then we'll have our additional mod pack after that. And that will be available before the map is released. As soon as we get it, it'll probably be available by next weekend. Hopefully we'll have that up for you. The other thing is we plan on getting you the PDF file also with all the instructions so you can go through it at your leisure, and hopefully I'll get the time to annotate that with the preview of the map, how everything works, that we did in the past. So if you have a question and there's a section in that PDF file that you want to go right to the certain minute of the video that we explain how it works, you'll be able to do that too. So up here on White Farm, we added some more trees as well, just to fill in some of the areas that are underused. They can always be pulled out, chopped down. But we added more trees up here on the hill. Just several, and there's actually some more bushes and grass as well on the map in different places. JD Farmer, you just type /host and then space and then DHANET to do a host if you wanted to host. I will say that I don't think we're going to be streaming too much longer tonight unless people have something in particular that they want to see, because, well, we're Apparently, Thernadad got a... Jeff got a donation from Thernadad as well. Cool. So yeah, there's some more trees around here. And Thernadad, our biggest fan, biggest donator. His number just keeps going up down there. That's why he has a building named after him. You donate that much money, you get a building named after you too. All right. The back road. Was there a back road over here? I think I did a back road. Yeah. Is it still over here? We put some trees down this road as well. Just another area where it seemed like it was lacking a little bit, so I did a tree-lined road down through here. Just to add some more scenery. So that's mostly what we've been working on, as well as all the other features that are built into the map. And the car washes are here. So yes, the project fast track, you can do it at any point in a project with this project point creator. You can, if you have 5% left and you just want to get it done, then you can drop the last 5 project points left and it'll finish up a project. You can do what I did and build the whole thing, but if you're going to build the whole thing, it goes so fast that you'll probably just have to log out and back into the game to see everything there in its stage, because it's not even the UPK's fault. It's a huge process to bring in all those pictures, all those objects all at once, and it just glitches out temporarily what you can actually see. So, but it will work. You can build your factories without building them if you want to buy, if you want to spend a lot of money to do it. Let's see. Nothing really new over here. Oh, there's a pizza plant factory down there. Let's see if I can go the shortcut. Yeah. All right. Yeah, a couple extra things. If you're not familiar, that does take eggs over here now with the new egg, our new chicken barns that produce eggs. And I gotta check one thing through the forest. I might not, I don't know if the sawmills are down here, but we will start you off with the 2 sawmills. I kinda thought the lots were empty. I gotta fix those as well. Actually, I think they start off on a clean save game, but not on our game, because they're built into the starting default vehicles XML file. Bad Ghost, thanks for the follow. Alright. Bum 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 bum. Trying to think if there's anything else. We have lots of planning to do. And GN Rectum. Rectum nearly killed him. Thanks for the follow. Gold. Gold is still works the same process. I don't know if we have any up here. Mining for gold. I'll head up that way. We'll see what happens. Jeff's just standing there. He's over there on Fishing Planet right now. Fishing his heart's content away. Blowing us off, yep. No, he didn't have any mods to showcase this week, because everything's getting wrapped up over here. Heading over. I do love the mountains in the background. Damien68, make sure you guys all come back when the mod is released on Farming Simulator. We need your votes.
He's definitely fishing.
Yeah. That's what I figured. FarmingSimulator.com's mod contest entries are due in by the 25th. Our map has to be up there. I'm going to do it relatively soon once we're all wrapped up. And then once they post them up, the voting will begin. And I believe you get to vote on best map and best mod. And just remember, A map can be voted for best mod as well. It goes up the list. You can get prizes in both categories for a map. Bleak Buffon came in 5th in best mod overall and 1st place in map last contest. So we're looking for maybe... Let's see if we can do better. And to kick off that whole thing, once the contest entries are released, we'll be doing live streams. We're going to do a 24-hour live stream at one point. And several others after I rest up from the 24-hour one. Get some people involved on the map when it first comes out. And also, get some votes. We'll get some banners up if other people, all those people that are live streaming, will have a download link if they want a link to where to go to vote as well. And see how well we can do. You never know. And Delt 3133, thanks for the follow. Damien.
There's gold.
Thanks for the
follow. I can see it.
You have gold. Awesome. Alright, so...
Just the first one has gold.
Gold on this map here is pretty simple, except for one minor little thing. You dump the gravel in, and actually you can see we have lots of tailings in the tailings bin. Actually, it's easier to see in a vehicle. You can pull up... When the tailings are full, the gold process stops. You pull up to the tailings bin, and that's all you do to empty it. And then you can continue to create gold. Some of the water is recycled onto this end over here, and the water, recycled water, again, works the same way as the tailings. If you go up to the box in front of the recycled water, here, let's... The box there is getting kind of big, but you get the picture. We'll move this out of the way for visual demonstration. Stand there a little while, it'll empty all your tailings. You bring water up to this plant, over by dumping it into the first container over here with your water trailer, and it's pretty low, as you can see. What we did on this version, and I don't know if it's on 1.3, I can't even remember what's in what version, but the output water tank here collects 80% of all water used, and if you drive in front of this box, it will recycle that water, and you can see the number of regular water going back up. We're at 39, 40, 43 and climbing, and this water goes down, the recycled water turns back into usable water on the other side. So just another one of those game mechanics that I thought would be pretty cool. Give you guys a lot of less trips running up and down the hill for water, because 80% of it has ended up back over here again, ready to go. Now with the gold, and we decided to keep it this way for a few reasons, but it still works the way we had intended, which is, and there's a lot of gold over here. You come up to the gold box and you see, oop, I don't have any gold. There was 447 gold there. Now, gold, and one of you guys out here can probably tell me better because I haven't played in so long. That was the sand one, was it? I don't know. Either way, gravel, sand. There's two different ones. And actually, maybe I'll put a label on there so people can remember. One of the gold things gets, but we'll show you them both. Once you do the transfer, your gold is not sold. Your gold is just shipped to the bank automatically. And we are going to put it on a truck in the rivers map where you got to transport it. But for this one here, there's just so many underlying components that have to be changed to do things that I decided to leave it and focus on getting the other stuff. It does recycle in 1.3 as well. That's cool. Yeah, we got that out for you. So the gold process is still the same as in version 1.3. If anybody is using the 1.3 or later, 1.3.2, map. It's the same process. It was different in 1.2, where gold would sell off automatically, and people were like, I'm not getting gold. Well, it actually just bypassed the whole process and sold as soon as it was made, and people didn't even ever see it up there. So we just added a step that makes you actually see your gold. And it's actually working as intended ever since the 1.3 version. And that is, which does confuse people, so we'll go over it really quickly. It's also in the tutorial video that we did. If you go over to your banks, and down here we do have a bank, and it's Wells Fargo. It's very simple. Follow the tutorials or watch the videos, or we'll even get this in the PDF, How to Operate Gold, in depth. If you come over to the ATM machine at a bank, you'll see you have your 447 gold. You can check your gold level. You can let it build up really high. When you're ready to sell your gold, notice I didn't want you to come up here, and that's one of the reasons why I did it. I didn't want to have it so you had to sell your gold. You can actually let it build up and then just sell it when you get a lot. So I separated the triggers. And I thought it kind of made sense, in my head anyway, put it over by the ATM machine. You can check your balance. You want to sell gold, you go in the bank, or in this case on this bank, you go through the drive-thru window where there's a yellow box. Now if you watch my money go up when I park here, money is raising up. And we're selling the gold, and it's going up pretty good clip. And there's a lot of gold. You can see your gold over here as well. 307 going down. 10 at a time. But that is why the gold is separate, two separate places where you can check it. So you don't actually have to, as soon as you step in this box, whether you're in a vehicle or out, it'll sell the gold. Me being out of the vehicle now. Once you pull out, it stops selling. So, gold is sold. Everybody's a little richer. Now you gotta remember, there's several people on the server, although they're dropping like flies. There's only two left, and one Dan just left. So, all the gold is split for everybody on the server. So even though we got quite a bit here, it was times four at the time I was selling it. And we'll go over to the other bank, which is operates the other gold mine. So that one was for sand, I believe it was. And the other one is for gravel. You're gonna need a faster PC. Well, you know, yeah, just ripped off my truck at the bank canopy. Actually, we have some guy. This map will take a little bit of PC power. It's not going to be one of those. But you'd be surprised at what I've seen people run this on in single player. It has a lot in it, but if you compare the map size with all the mods we integrated, it's still smaller than several other maps because of all our optimizations that we did under the hood. Yeah, Razor33, YouTube. YouTube link is down below the page here. It will be up on YouTube, and it will be available in the past broadcasts. Actually, the latest broadcast for a little while, but past broadcasts for a week, I think they keep them up there. So yeah, you'll be able to catch those on YouTube. You also can go back and look at a lot of our other past broadcasts as well. And there is a whole, or 90% map tutorial on the map as well, because we added stuff in even since we did the tutorial. It just never stops around here. But, catch that. Oops, I went in the fence. I don't even know where I'm going. Back up! It's a dead end. Oh yeah, the soccer game. Anybody missed the? Did he sell off the balls? Or are there still soccer balls around? Where'd all the soccer balls go?
I was gonna ask that earlier.
They were here before. Is there still wheat in that truck? Oh, the soccer ball spawner's gone too? Or are they around this?
No, the spawner's gone too. They were right here.
Oh, maybe I... Well, let's see if they're in the store. I might have not carried them over by accident. It was a quick thing, you know? Yeah. They're not in the store. I have to get our soccer ball spawner back on the map. Jeez, what was I thinking? Yeah, I get lost on my own map all the time. The unfortunate fact is that everybody here plays more than I do because I spend so many hours actually working on it that, heck, I don't even know sometimes which way is up. Yeah, eventually after we're gonna get this one released and play a little while, then get back to Rivers and give you guys some time to work this map. By the time you're done with Rivers, I mean with PB2, we might have Rivers ready. Give you one last, probably, geez, it's gonna be a while, so at least get you closer to the end of FS15 and closer to 17. Who put that bail there? So here's your other bank, and again, it works similar to that one. The other one comes down here, so that was sand and gravel would come to key bank. You would walk up, and there is no gold, but if you did have gold, you would just come over to the yellow box by the door and sell your gold by standing in the yellow box. So that's how the gold works. While we're over here, and Trinidad, stay back, because when you're in display triggers, I can't see them. Over here, and I do gotta fix the 110 entry, or the LI, or whatever 10, I can't remember what it's called, for coffee, so it doesn't have the brackets around it. But coffee replaced bird seed at the Piggly Wiggly. It was more appropriate. And if I can get to Dunkin' Donut, Dancin' Donuts now, I'll check, and that display should pop up. There was like four of you guys in it when I tried to check it last time.
Dan was attacking me and MasterChef, so it turned into 2-on-1 Car Wars.
If you use an iPhone, Cortana, remind Siri to remind Dave. Cortana doesn't even take notes yet. I tried that. Boy, when she can take notes, it's going to be awesome. I'll get rid of these notepads on my desk. Hey, Bad Ghost 11, how's it going? You can call me Albereth. You can call me Dave. Just don't call me late for dinner. Oh, look, a floating tree. Yeah, that's what happens. So, yep, those were put in. Yeah, we got a floating tree over here on Highway 9. Let me put a note on the notepad.
Master Chief said to tell you, too, that there's a floating tree out back of Dunkin' Donuts.
I'm sure that's the one. It's right there. The little things. That's why we gotta stop adding stuff, because then you gotta fix a bunch of stuff. Stay out of my box.
I should go park in it.
I'm not getting it anyway, which is weird. Alright, I gotta check that display trigger. Alrighty, so that's Dancing Donuts. Those will be fixed. The display will tell you actually how much coffee is at Dancing Donuts before they need a refill. Hourly sales. Put a little spinner on the sign. I thought that was a pretty cool touch. That's a new model that we got in. One more time through the Speedway, and then we're going to probably call it for tonight. We'll give you another
look. I'm putting shoes right here.
Is there two of them?
Yeah, I'm parked under it.
Hang on. I see one right there. That's not the one you're parked under? So,
no.
Okay, there's two of them. Okay, well, we've got two floating trees to remove. Awesome. I love the way trees grow in the air like that. Okay, good deal. You think it's spinning too fast? I was trying to figure out a... Yeah, need police cars at the donut shop. Spinning fast. Yeah, it's spinning a little fast. It's very tricky to get the spinning speed down.
Did you add stuff to the fairgrounds?
Did we add stuff to the fairgrounds? Not since the last time we did a preview.
I thought you put the cranberries and stuff in there.
Nope, didn't put them in down there. We're required... The fairgrounds is such a big... monster that it would require a lot of extra work, and I don't want to screw anything up on that because it's working. It's bad enough we got floating trees.
But no, it's just because Len Bowen was asking anything more in fairgrounds or farmers market.
Did we fix the switches for the power lines? There's one switch for the power lines. Yeah, I won't have to tell you this. That are is built into the map to turn them on and off, and it's already off here, so we don't have it. But what I'll do real quick is I'm going to give you guys a quick look. Well, first we'll go through the donations one more time and thank everybody, not necessarily by name, but I'll show you them. And if anybody gets a donation, those guys that donated today, well, Thernadad's already up there, so, but anybody new, as long as they're in by, like, say, noon tomorrow, so I can finish these banners up, as well as Twitch streaming banners. But now that I don't have all the lag because everybody's following me around, we'll go through, and all these people have donated to help us out over here, and it's very much appreciated. And I don't know how else to thank them, but I wanted to give them some recognition to get them in the map, so... Yep, the silver... guys have donated more than 10 up to 49 bucks. The gold ones have all donated more than $50, which really floors me, because look at that line of gold banners. And their Twitch names are all right there, right along the top of the banners there. And we thank each and every one of you. And even if you don't feel obligated, heck, I couldn't donate. This is all... only money I've actually made in the past 3 years is from you guys, so I can't donate to other people's streams, or I would. But if we win the mod contest, hey, you never know. Speaking of which, when we start that big 24-hour live stream, I do have $100 of those donations that came in a couple weeks ago saved up for prizes for the 24-hour live stream will be given away, and if we win the mod contest, there will be a lot more prizes coming after that. If you want to get your Twitch banners in once more, 1024 by 512 is the resolution. I don't have time to create everybody's graphics, so you can send me a graphic. You'll get your banners up on the Speedway. If you're going to, please only if you plan on streaming Pleasant Valley version 2 when it comes out. And we'll have a big marathon. Maybe we'll get some of these guys that and do a multi-stream with several. I do have some ideas for a multi-stream as well. I'm going to send out a message to a lot of people that stream, you'll see a message from me soon enough about some cool things that maybe you'd be interested in. So we'll get you more information on that when we get all the extra stuff nailed down. JD Farmer, I don't know if Jeff sent me a billboard, or he created a, but he didn't know if it was supposed to be in the Speedway. He thought it was for your personal use, but if you're streaming, I can make it, and I can make it happen, because he has a copy of it, I'm sure. Let's see. At this point, I'm going to shut down this game and bring you up on career mode, because there's a few things that you do not see in server play that I think you'll be interested in. So, Thernadad, I don't know if you heard that. I'm shutting down, and I'm going to boot up a career game for the rest of this broadcast and show them a clean start game. I'm leaving this up, the server up, but I won't be on it.
No, fishy.
So here we will start up a career save game in slot 17. And we'll do... it doesn't really matter. Normal mode. I usually recommend hard mode because everything's geared toward hard mode that's integrated into the map. Alright, JD, we'll get your banner in here. And Minever5, thanks for the follow. And KW, thanks for giving everybody 100 points that's watching. Awesome. When you first load into a map, it'll take not as long as it does when you have a big map, but give me a minute here. We'll be loaded right up. It is a big map, but at least there's not 1,000 vehicles in the file. And waiting. I hear boat noises. That's a good sign. Start. This is what you're going to be presented with when you first come in, and you can't even move. This is only at the beginning of a new save game. You have two options. And option A is with buyable objects. Option B is without. Now, because we all know option A, you have to go and you actually have to buy your objects on the map. For this demonstration, we're going to choose option... oh, crap. Well, for this demonstration, I'm going to do option A. We'll reload back in for option B in a minute because somebody asked a question about the power lines. So, option A... we're in the map, and let me go find a really slow vehicle, because that's all we're starting out with, that's close by to the farm, purple farm, and somebody said that this was up off the ground, that's another thing that has to be fixed. Here we are, and there's a few things that I wanted to show you. Offline, you have traffic, which you guys didn't. You had it in 1.3, but what you didn't have is parked cars. Yeah, parked cars. So if you're playing a single-player game offline, there's a few more parked cars around the speedway and around the fairgrounds. We'll zip around there and show you what we've done, what mess we've created. Without completely lagging the map out, I didn't fill every parking spot, but scattered some parked cars around, and it's extra stuff that's under this behind the scenes that you just haven't seen until I ran a single player. Oh yeah, the speedway, if you didn't notice, the stands have changed, which we could check those out, but you see there's some parked cars going down along the front, not a lot, a few here, a few there. To the person that was asking about the fixing the doodahickey power lines. There's power lines out there in the distance somewhere. You can't really see them from here. But basically, you would come up to... Actually, geez, it's such a long walk. Let me see if I can drive up there. Being lazy. Let me drive up there, because it's kind of hidden. It's when you first come into a game, especially if you're setting it up on a server, if you're a single player, it's not a big deal. You can do this whenever you want, or not do it at all if you want, like the power lines. But if you're setting up a server, don't want people monkeying around, but don't want that big row of power lines that we showed you over there before, then you can come up here and go into this area, arrow. And here you have an option to remove the power lines. And C, it costs nothing. And if I hit C, it will remove the power lines from the map. Just one of those things that there is one pylon in the middle of a field. And then you have to walk all the way down here, because all this extra space was supposed to be for additional objects that may come in like 2.1 point who knows what, but when you're done with deciding, you can go over here and close this control room area, which is C again, and then you can get out of here. Let's get back to the vehicle I was in. And you'll notice the arrow by the door is gone. Can't do anything. Now, if you decide not to play with viable objects, guess what? You've got power lines. There's no way around it. Everything's on the map. I believe either that or you don't have them. We'll test that out in a minute. But right now I took the power lines off the map, so that big set of power lines that was up there in the north are gone. But wanted to drive you down here, show you some more of the vehicles, and these parking spaces were added as well this past week, so we had a place to park vehicles. And those are all loaded in from the Giants engine. They're not actually there, and they will be different colors every time you load up the game. A different vehicle could be in the parking spot, so that's pretty interesting in itself. Left control to run. Yeah, well, I know you can run. So we still have all the viable objects on the map. We left those in. What we'll do is the next option, I'm going to start another game, and we'll show you what happens if you decide not to have viable objects. Now, I tried this next feature to get it so the cars were at the fairgrounds only when the fair was running. But it didn't like it. So cars are down here in the parking lot at all times. Just pretend they're visiting or setting up or whatever, you know? Some things you just can't do, but there are several vehicles down here if you're playing offline at the fair. Look at all the parked cars down here. So yeah, it'll look a little bit. Now the people, it worked fine. We did add that in as well this time around, is the people will start walking around when the fair starts. The parked cars, I tried the same theory, and it was either have them all the time or not have them at all. So for now, we get what we get. But there's several parked cars around the fairgrounds as well. How about a crop dusting? Yeah, I wish we had a plane that flies. I'd be doing crop dusting. That's why the airport runways are where they are. And yeah, we might put some decorative planes at the airport up above in the north, but not on the other runways, because they're just like landing strips. The biggest thing is if I put decorative planes, they can't be on the landing strips, because heck, if we get real planes to fly, we want to be able to fly in and out. You never know. Somebody might just make one for the mod contest. They know how bad people want it. I want one that we can fly and spread the stuff in the fields. We did have one for FS-13, but apparently the guy who made that script, it's locked, nobody can read it, and he hasn't updated it, so somebody else that's clever and knows script writing will have to try to make a plane that flies. And that is not me. So there's some parked cars over here. Now, next thing I wanted to show you is we're going to load in and do option number 2, which is a new save game. And I want to just give you guys an idea of what to be prepared for if you decide to not use the buyable objects in the beginning. Yeah, man, I really would love crop dusting. And it is a big map, but that's what makes it awesome. If you're here for the first time, what we really, our main goal here originally, which I'm surprised there's as many single players as it, is we have a really active group, probably one of the most active server groups online. That I know there are some other ones out there that are crazy like us too, but I wanted to create a map that we could play for several months that wouldn't be done in it, you know, that we're not starting to do in the everything over. And that's why there is so much content, and I'm surprised how many people say, hey, I'm gonna tackle that sucker single player. If we go without buyable objects by clicking the red X, we have now everything should be built on the map. Let's get a vehicle on the same farm as before. It's the fastest tractor I have right now. Actually, let's do this. I don't have the money cheat on the server, but I do have a way to... We have enough vehicles that I'm sure if I just sell a couple of these suckers, I can buy myself a race car. And we can move a lot faster. That's what we want. So, race car it is. Starter up. 4, 5, 6. Drive controls are on. Alright. Viable objects are already off. Now, I have $83,971. You have all your water towers right at the beginning of the game. The gravel pit's open. Everything will be open for your pleasure if you decide to choose that mode to go around, which creates an interesting issue on this map. So it is like a fast-forward mode. If you're not going to have a lot of time, don't want to invest in all those buyable objects, you can see they're all on here. Several of those buyable objects create money over time, including the basketball court and the soccer stadium and the big mansion on the hill. So let's see exactly, if we fast forward time here to the top of this hour, if you choose this option, there's no way around it. You're going to get the money right from the beginning every hour, and we're at about 84,000. We'll round it off. And the money for the top of the hour brings us to, and it should be pretty good, $84 to $92 every hour. It's still going up a little bit. So, yeah, you're getting about $8,000 an hour on top of just by skipping that mode altogether. Not for doing absolutely nothing. So it's not recommended, but again, we threw it in there to give you the option. Some people don't have a million hours to complete a map this size, and we won't use that option, but I know that some people have to. I shouldn't have that many hours to complete a map this size. But that's the main thing. All the objects are bought. Now, the interesting thing is, I don't know if because the power lines were a delete option, if they're not there at all, or if they're there because we're not using viable objects. So let's go check it out. Zipping across the map. And it looks like I see something out there. Nope. If you decide not to use viable objects, you don't get the power lines. That's all there is to it. They'll be gone. So, no power lines whatsoever around the map. You will still have to build the factories and stuff. There was a building over here, wasn't there once? No, I guess not. Is that a fishing dock area? I can't even remember. Let me see if there's a trigger over here. If it is, it's something I have to fix. Or is it just a wide turn? That is so weird. I guess it was always that way. Just seems like I put a lot of dirt there for nothing to be here. Who knows? Guess it's always been that way. It's just weird starting a map from scratch. You see all the things that are... I mean, we haven't done it too often. So, yep. You have to come down here for the water. You have both meters, all the water towers. And again, for first-time watchers, you pick up water here at Culligan. And you can walk by these meters. Or you can, actually pick them up at the water towers, but you have to fill them up first. So the way to fill them up is to come back to the stairway and stand in front of the control box and suck in unfiltered water. And you'll see it fill up on this side, loads up this Culligan plant, so you can pick up water down here. And option number two, which is a viable object, fills up this side, which pumps water out to all the water towers around the map. And you don't have to stand here too long. You can see unfiltered water goes up very fast, and then it filters at 1,000 per second. So it's just one of those things. Every now and then, if you run out of water on the map, because we did try to make it so you can't find another place to get water on the map, other than the water towers or the Culligan plant. If you run out of water on the map, you just gotta come down here and pump some more. But there's always workarounds. There are people that put in the fire hydrants. Understandable for different play styles. But you can see down here, there's your meters. Left side showing how much is unfiltered and right side showing how much of it is filtered. And the right side should match the left side eventually. But in this mode, you get everything right off the bat. Awesome. So if anybody else has any questions, we're just about done here for today. We'll take another quick spin around. I showed you the gravel pit. If you're first timers here, the gravel pit looks entirely different at the start of a game. As well as I added some more bushes and trees on these little side roads to make it a little bit more interesting drive. But let's go right over to the gravel pit, shortcut, short way. Mountains in the background are all new. And on a clean map, offline, I'm still getting 60 frames a second with everything that's on here, as you can see. Occasional dips, but if you, and I'm running a GTX 660, which is by no means a bad card, but it's by no means a really super duper card either. So if you have any halfway decent card, you should be able to run this map without any problems. Slight dips in certain areas. But in the beginning, when you get to the gravel pit, you have some work to do. because... Whoa! Crazy driving. This is what your gravel pit looks like when you first start. The world's first gravel pit that actually has to be dug out. You have narrow passageways, and as you dig it out, these walls will move. Yes, there are some, and I know that people are going to bring this up when the time comes, but when you have movable objects that are very strange shapes, like these walls, and it's one of those things that it's do we or don't we? We could stick with the old piles and boring, but what happens is when a mesh trigger is wrapped around a big object, and you get a little bit of it here, as you might have noticed, you see how I'm on something that's invisible? And I just want to show you this, because we are aware of it. It's invisible.
Can disconnect it.
But what you're getting is the trigger trying to wrap around that object, and I'll show you right here how a trigger is wrapped around the object. So I'm walking on this invisible area here, even though it's wrapped. Now, most places on this, the walls move back, whereas this one moves underground. So yeah, there will be a little bit invisible until you have the pile all gone, but eventually you won't have that invisible areas. You'll see most of the rest of them are pretty decent because they move back into the walls. There were certain places where we couldn't do that because there's nothing on the other side that we could move it into. So in those instances, we had to make it so they go down under the ground, and that's when you'll get those triggers where the blank areas are. Just wanted to mention that. It was either have the moving walls or and live with that little issue, or not have them at all. And we decided to go with that because they're really cool to actually have to dig out your whole gravel pit. And that gravel area top is really the main area because most of these planes move out of the way backwards, so it's not an issue, rather than down. So you literally have to dig out the whole coal area. And it goes way back there. If you're on 1.3 map, you know how far back you can actually dig out that coal. There's actually 22 million in coal there ready to be dug out. 22 million of every product on the map. And there's the stone, same way, it's all filled in. And you'll be digging your way out. Salt's down here sticking out. Anywhere where you see those planes sticking out of the walls, you gotta dig it out yourself. And you can widen the passages. And in the beginning, you can't get some of the bigger vehicles like that Cat 994 down here right off the bat, unless you dig out a little bit. Because they're just too big to squeeze through some of the gaps, which was part of the plan. And another big part of the plan, even though it was to make it so that you can't go through the whole loop of the gravel pit without digging out this wall right here. Now, you might be able to with a car, but you're not going to get a lot of vehicles up this wall to go around. rolling over. Yeah, you can get around that one with the car. I don't know about this one. Let's see. It's narrow. Yeah, I'm going to end up on my roof this time, though. But anyhow, there you have it. Me upside down in the gravel pit. So you have to dig your way through. All right, what do we have? Any questions for anybody before we call it? Who's not on this? How can you start? Oh, I missed that. I'll have to scroll back up there. How can you start build because you're on this map and it's already built? Is there something you are doing wrong? If you are on this map, then there's something you're doing wrong because this map isn't released yet. If you're on version 1.3.2 and you have buildings already built, then you don't have the Universal Process Kit mod installed in your folder, which, and if you don't have that, you probably don't have several. So go back to the PDF file that came with the map, open it up, download all the links to the files that you need to run it, because there are several. The only reason why the factories would all be pre-built would be if the Universal Process Kit was not installed in your mods folder. And if that was the case, none of them would work anyway. Same way, if you come in and you have, if you see buyable objects that have, for instance, somebody's mentioned to me on the other day, why do I have Applebee's sitting inside a rock? Or why is the water tower inside the rock? These rocks that used to be here are actually placeholders, so people don't park a vehicle in there when the water tower is built or it'll be launched. So the rock disappears, the water tower appears, and you need to have the map buyable object script in your map, which is on modportal.com, map buyable objects, in order for them to function properly. And those two mods are a necessity for this map. And those are where most people that download it go wrong. They don't have one of those two map, and all of a sudden they think it's our problem, but the fact is that they didn't read, I know a lot of people don't like to read directions, but trust me, look over the PDF file, and also there is a translation, lost in translation issue as well, because there are several people using different languages, but we tried to make it as clear in the PDF file as possible, so try to look through it. Use Google Translate to translate it. Do I use a flight stick to run the wood stuff? No, I don't. I don't use a stick to do my wood. And why is your editor, say, not responding or just show a black screen? And that's when you are doing map editing. Every map you load shows not responding, and depending on the speed of your computer, you might have to wait a while till it actually responds. I don't know why Giants has that happen when they're loading maps, it goes to not responding. You just gotta wait through it. If you're getting a black screen, I have no idea. Then you'll have to talk to Giants for them. Can you see the speedway? Yes, you can. No, you can't have the map. Not yet. Sorry. Giants contest. And I get a proxy server. When you go to the link, you say to get what? What link are you going to? And if, try a different web browser possibly. If you're using the 1.3.2, the links work. There's a link right down below for all the 1.3.2 mods. If you're new here, you want to get the 1.3.2 version of this map. There's one folder that has everything you need. Or if you're missing a mod, it's right there below the stream. Grab it. You can grab it right out of that folder. Here's our speedway. And the speedway does have the automated starting line if you're going to race people. Kind of fun. I wish we had a lap counter. I haven't figured out how to do that yet. Count laps. Put up a big scoreboard out there. That would be awesome. You can hit the O to go, and it removes the speed gate. And when you come back around at the end of your race, you can hit O to stop and put it back up. Not quite as fast with the little truck, but all the donation banners are in the speedway. And one thing I did not mention is you'll notice the grandstands have changed. That was one of those things that if you're running the 1.3.2 version, or any version prior to that, we had different grandstands that were, oh my gosh, in a lot of people won't even know that. Understand the terms, but the number of triangles that have to render on the map were like 500,000 per level of seats. And we got these ones here that are actually less than 20,000 per stand. So if you were having lag issues driving by the speedway, that should clear it up quite a bit. Let's see what my frame rates. They're still a little bit lower at the speedway here, but before it would drop. When we're looking away from the grandstands, it's fine. But before, it was much bigger drop. And again, I'm not on the best graphics card, but I'm on a decent one. It's getting by. Devo343, thanks for the follow. Why is everyone so into a road that goes around and around? I don't know. It's a lot of fun on the server when we have races. Oh, the starter map by Robbie at FSUK gives you a starter, a proxy server? Well, if you can't get his starter map, I don't know, the FSUK might have changed the link or something. Look for starter maps. There's tons of them out there. You don't have to use the one that I point to. That one's the one I liked. Try a different browser. I haven't been there in a little while. There's lots of different starter maps. There's even 4X starter. That's a single size one. There's 4X ones out there that are available too if you wanted to do a monster map like this one. There's a 16X one that doesn't really work all the way, but yeah, that's out there too. To see the banners? Oh, you wanted to see the banners again? I can drive by the banners. Did Ollie? I don't think I got one from Ollie the Viking. But if he had one and he's streaming, send it in sometime before tomorrow. Sometime, yeah, give me it as early as you can by, well, tomorrow. I'm going to be trying to finish up all of those and get them in here by, like, noon would be nice. And then I'll get you.
Channel, they're not ad. Link to gyzo.com.
And then we'll get you your banner in here. And I'll go by one more time all the banners, just so everybody can see. And if I missed anybody, the donators, just say something. Send me an email, albert@gmail.com, or message me through our forum website. I did receive some donations early on before I actually used the donation link, and those donations don't have your stream names. I don't want to put personal names up here. So if you were one of those people, just send me, I'm such and such, and I donated this, and use my name. And we'll get those in here as well, because there are a couple that are not here. Or if you prefer to remain anonymous and you want yours pulled down, we can do that as well, but just let me know by tomorrow. But there's all the donators. Once again, thank you very much. Do you have Giants Editor in the 5.03 or the 6? I mean, the latest 6.03 version shouldn't give you any errors when you in the editor. You have to unzip the files. Remember, you have to extract them all before you can edit any map i3D file as well. You can't do it while it's zipped up. Jaleel, too, thanks for the follow. But, yeah, those are more questions that should be asked in the map classes. But, hey. Taking our slow ride down donation lane. And then we'll take a slow ride down streamer lane. And I hope all these streamers go live when 2.0 comes out and get their vote for Pleasant Valley buttons up on their website. We gotta get this thing. We gotta win this contest. Well, we don't have to. Actually, hope for the best, expect the worst. It's my attitude. We'll see what happens, you know? And here we go. So we got Twitch TV Koboomba and Unsparring. Lars Monson, Nefarious, and St. Louis, which is, these guys are all part of my team, so I kind of stuck them in there for them real quick. And Hunter Farmer 101, and myself, and Big Daddy, and DD711. Then we have One Eagle 103, Viper 278, and Drool's stream at, which I guess it's Drool01. He should have had his stream address on there, but hey, that's okay. I'm sure it's Drool01. You can watch us. Actually, most of these guys are streaming 1.3.2 now. Jake2024, thanks for the follow. Yeah, Butler's over here somewhere. You're out there. Was it on the end? I do use a steering wheel. I'm just cruising around with my steering wheel. I got a G, not an expense, Logitech GeForce GT. You know, Trout didn't send a banner in for a stream. You know, there are certain people that I want to put them up there. There's your banner there, Butler. I gotta put out a last request. I mean, I can stick up there like I did for my guys. My time is limited to get heavy into the design, but if they just want a Twitch banner, or if somebody else wants to make them one and send it and see if they want to get it approved. And I'll even tell you this. And Big Chris, again, I know you're part of our team, but I didn't have any graphics ready for yours. You will get one up there. I haven't had a chance to talk to you what you want on it or anything. So let's put it this way. Troutmouth, Gunnin, Gamers, if they're planning on streaming, 21-something, and Simulator Way of Life, just message me. I will make something, and it might be generic, the purple Twitch thing with your stream thing on it or whatever, but I can put something up there, and I'd like to see them guys up there as well, because they've been here since the start. You know, those are the guys that got me going, and I really hate to not acknowledge them, but I don't have the time to custom design 100 banners. But if somebody thinks of something, throws up something together for Trout, and hey, we can get it over to Trout and see if he approves it, and I'll put it in there. That would be great. And same way with some of the other guys. If you know them, you can help them out by creating their banner. I know that several of these banners were created by people other than the streamers themselves, and they don't have the time to do it, but neither do I. I'm crunch time now. We've got 14, well, it's today, the 14th, so 11 days left to wrap everything up and get it done, which is a lot more than you think. And we don't want to, yeah. Yep. I know Trout will be. I'd like to get a banner. If somebody can create Trout's on there, that would be awesome. And I'll message out, like I said, I'll extend the deadline to Sunday for missing banners for people. We'll give you till Sunday. I just got to get it wrapped up. I was hoping to get it done. Thanks, Jake2024, and whoever popped up that I'm watching all this stuff stream by and I missed somebody's name. GamerBro2236. Wow, we got a lot of follows tonight, which is cool. Make sure you all stop back after that mod contest is released. Sorry I missed the shout-out to whoever. They come by so late, too. I probably have to scroll back a mile to find them. You guys probably joined a hour ago, but... what do I do now? Yeah, so... we'll give you an extension. Try to get him here tomorrow. Sunday at the latest to get your banners in. So I can get this wrapped up. I got a few things I gotta go back in and edit out anyway. Obviously some floating trees. Follow sound is to wake me up. I glanced over a little too late to miss the first one. Shelby Brian 22, thanks for the follow. I caught that one before it even popped up. It'll be another 10 minutes. 16 tonight. Awesome. Yeah, so when the map contest starts, we're going to try to stream earlier for those of you that are not in the United States. Later for those of you who are not. Whenever we possibly can, we'll be doing some streaming to get the voting up. We want to get some votes. The prizes aren't little for those first place prizes, that's for sure. A 3D printer is first place in the mod, first place mod, which is a value of like $4,000. Thanks, Grizzly. Thanks for doing a fine job. We also try to support you guys as much as possible. That's another reason why we're going to be live streaming when the map comes out. If you download the map from the mod contest when it comes out, I'll guarantee you that we will be around here for quite a bit as soon as we realize that it's up there. I don't know when they're going to actually post them on their site, but that's another reason for us to be here as much as possible, because we want to be here to answer any questions right away for you guys. If you have any issues, we want to be here to help you guys get through that initial process, which, and the forums are always up as well, pvmods.engine, well, no, whatever it is, forums address, it's down below. Just click on our Dagenet Mods logo, or exclamation point website, I think it is, but yeah, we'll be here. Or you can ask questions over there. I can't read all the forum posts. Thank you, Viper, again, for all the help you do answering most of the questions. I actually had some people think you were part of our team because of all the work you do. But no, he's been taking that on himself, and it saves me a lot of extra responding, which I try to respond to things that are asked directly, and it may take me a few days, especially at this point when we're getting everything ready. Yeah, you have issues. Yeah, I mean with the map when it comes out. Hopefully there won't be any. But you know, there always are. You never know. That follow sound is actually twitchalerts.com, one of their default sounds. Yeah, 128k upload. Oh my gosh, that's slow. I couldn't do it on the 512 upload speed. I had to upgrade my, well, you guys upgraded my internet. Let's see, I can tell you lots of stuff that your donations have done, but one of them is my second monitor, which was the first thing. You guys hit that in a day, which was awesome. And that helped me. As you remember, I had this monitor to cut out every 5 minutes, and the Twitch streams weren't nearly as good back then. That was the first thing. Then you also got us a year's worth of high-speed internet with a little bit better 5 megabytes down upload, which helped cut down our time on the uploads and getting files ready and all that fun stuff. There was the Dropbox Pro for a year, you guys. We just got that last week, so we can now get the files to you a lot quicker, a lot easier using the Dropbox. There's just tons of models that we bought for the Rivers map, as well as here, the buildings around the edge outside, because we don't have a 3D modeler on staff, but Turbo Squid has 3D models that are royalty free when you purchase them, so we were able to get some extra stuff in from that. And the list goes on and on. So it's been a huge help. Not only for me personally, but it was awesome. No, mine is 30 megabyte down, 5 megabyte up. I used to be 12 down and 1 up, which was not enough to do the streaming and everything. But 30 and 5 has been fine, a lot better. Alright, everyone, I think that's about it for tonight. Unless anybody has any further questions, we'll be back here soon. We'll get the wrap up. We'll do some, for like I said, just in case you're joining us for the first time. On our schedule, we currently have map classes for Tuesday and Friday, and then this preview is usually starts on Friday. But stop in. We'll be doing some type of gaming, whether it be here on this map here, most likely this week. I'm not 100% sure what we'll be up to, but we've started another game over here. I'm going through one heck of a field. There we go. Tuesday and Friday we'll be streaming the PV 2.0, us actually playing. I will be streaming during those hours rather than map making and finishing up everything. So we'll have some crops on the fields. Who knows? There's a plane. The plane also got the... So yeah, we just started over to get ready for streaming. So if anybody else has any questions, now's the time to ask. You're a welcome outdoors traveler. We're really getting close. Currently, do we stream at other times? Tuesday, Friday is what we've been doing. And Saturday. Oh, yeah. We do, we are going to do... I forgot all about this. Tomorrow is Flashback Saturday, which is scheduled... Oh, gosh, it's on the list. 7 p.m., is it? 8 p.m.? I don't remember. I think it's 7 o'clock, where we go back to... And I don't even have the flashback files ready yet. I've been so busy on this thing. But we'll get something up there. We're going to flash back to the next map, which is either... What did we do last time? Anybody remember? Was it Pleasant Valley version 3? It's our first Fences map this week. 2013 Fences version 1. That's what we'll be... And the files are not ready for the flashback yet, so you don't need to throw that link up. We'll do that tomorrow. People are allowed to join us if they still have Farming Simulator 2013 on there. I'll be doing the flashback show tomorrow at 7 o'clock. And we'll just be doing a quick rundown of what our first fence is. We're going through the series of every map that I made. And that is like the fourth or fifth in the series. And that will probably be the last flashback show until after the mod contest. So, one more time, we'll get that in there tomorrow. And then, after that. All the mods in your Dropbox, there are two folders. If you're already running down below, if you're already running the map on 1.3 or 1.3.1, you just need the files 1.3.2 folder. If you're running the map for the first time, down below, 1.3.2 map folder is all the files that are available. Do you need them all? No. Well, you need several of them. And again, another little thanks for the follow. I can't even read this. Let me see. Welcome, Wolfie12CA, GamerBro223. We got lots of them. They're all scrolling at the bottom. Jake2000, 24. But anyway, all right. Thanks for the banner, Ollie. We'll get that in there. Anyhow, yeah. Where was I? I lost track of what the heck I was saying. Not all those files are needed. They're all recommended. They're all as error-free as we could get them. Actually, we try to keep error-free, and several of them are needed. The fuel trailers, the box trailer. So they're there because they've been tested with the map, and some of them are definitely needed. We didn't separate them, and it's so I recommend you grab them all, and if there's vehicles in there that you don't use later on, get rid of them. But if there's mods in there that aren't vehicles, like the external accounts, it's not necessary. That's this mod here. Brings up a bank. It's great for servers, but you don't need it if you're playing single player. Just delete your external account mod. Several of the other ones are definitely needed to run the map. And thanks, Razor133, for the compliment. Great stream tonight. And everyone else, I think we'll be calling it a night. And if you have more questions tomorrow while we're streaming FS13, flashback Saturday, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, think of your questions. We'll answer them during that stream. We can answer questions on anything. Well, anything that we know about. So, until then, thanks everyone for stopping by, and have a great night. We'll catch you later.